I am a rape survivor.
Am a rape survivor.
Am a rape survivor. When I was in my last year of college, I was raped. And a month after that, I found out that I was pregnant as a result of that rape.
When I was a senior in high school, I attended a Halloween party at a college near my home. And later in the night, I was drugged and I was raped. A few weeks later, I found out that I was pregnant as a result of the rape.
I was raped by someone that I knew for a very short time. I went to the hospital and I was told that I was infertile and could never have kids. So I went on living my life, and 4 months down the road, I found out that I was in fact pregnant.
It was very difficult at first. When I was raped, I went through, I think, what a lot of women go through, and that's just wanting to pretend like it had never happened. I wasn't very successful in that to begin with, but then finding out that I was pregnant just made the reality hit home all the more that this was happening, this had happened.
I grew up Catholic, so I knew a lot about the pro-life movement and what an abortion was. But when it came to my own situation, I felt that I didn't have a choice.
Abortion was a consideration early on. When I found out that I was pregnant, I sought the assistance of some counselors on campus, and all three of them, they told me that women who are raped, that it's just very traumatic for them to have children from those rapes. I asked them if they had counseled women who were in my position before. They said no, but that this was just kind of common knowledge.
Immediately after finding out that I was pregnant, and I found out in the hospital, abortion was a thought. It went through my head, oh, there's no way, no, I can't do this, not with this person, why is this happening to me?
I had a lot of friends who supported me and my choice to have an abortion, offered to help me pay and drive me, but I also had some friends who were against that. The night before my scheduled abortion, I finally confided in my cousin, Erin, who is one of my very good friends. And she just looked at me with tears falling down her face, and she said, "Liz, you know yourself, and you know you're smart, and you know that's a baby, and you can't kill a baby." But at that point, it was still, I didn't have a choice. I mean, I couldn't not have an abortion.
And unfortunately, for a time, I convinced myself that what my counselors were telling me was perhaps true, that the best choice for my child was to not be brought into a world under such circumstances.
And I set my alarm to wake up the next morning to murder my own child, but my alarm didn't go off, and I didn't get up, and I never rescheduled.
I'm happy to say that that I couldn't get my mind to the point where I could actually go to a clinic and have an abortion. And I remember vividly the day that I decided that I was having my child, and I think it was the first time that I had smiled in 3 months. It was just such a relief, and I just felt an absolute joy in knowing that my child was going to be born, and I thought, we're going to make it, and we're going to make it together.
But it only took me about an hour to realize that I was pregnant for a reason, and this child was meant to be mine, and after that, you know, abortion was no longer a thought or an option.
I decided to go into an open adoption with my son. He's where he needs to be. You know, I was 17. I was young. I was still being parented. My mom was still making my lunches every day for school, and I was in no place to be a parent. And it seemed to fit. And when I met Brian and Jen, it was right. And when at a time in my life when there were so many wrongs, it was nice to finally have a right.
After I gave birth to my daughter, I faced several difficult obstacles that a lot of women who conceive through rape and then decide to raise their child face. There are very few legal protections that protect them from their rapist. Only 17 states within the United States have passed laws that restrict the parental rights of men who rape. As a result of that, men who rape are allowed custody and visitation privileges over the children that they father through their crimes. And I think that although I was able to protect my daughter, that I lost a lot of the rights that I should have been able to exercise. But I had to do it because the law wasn't there for me. So what I decided to do was to enroll in law school. So I started at law school and I decided that never again was I going to be a victim of the law. I think that the problem stems from the way that we as a society, and that's in popular culture, that's our politicians, talk about the pregnant raped woman. We talk about this woman and we assume that she is a victim of her pregnancy, not just a victim of her rape.
Brayden is, he saved me. Sometimes I think that God sent me a little angel to hang out with me for 9 months while I was healing from the rape. And I could not be more thankful for that.
There have been only 2 studies in the United States ever looking at the feelings that women who are pregnant through rape have towards their child. And both studies dismiss the idea that the vast majority of women have negative thoughts.
Well, my son means, he's everything to me. I mean, you know, like most other survivors that I've met, they say they gave them a reason to continue on in life and live. And he's done that for me. He's motivated me more than anyone in this world.
I love him so much, and he's given me more than I can ever imagine.
My daughter is just the absolute greatest gift for me. I think that the biggest problem I've had in recovering from my rape is that for so long I wanted to go back and be the person that I was before the rape. And what my daughter taught me is that there is value to who I have become after my rapes. And the value is in being a mother to her, in learning to love in an absolute unconditional way, to start seeing the innocence and the beauty in life again. She's taught me all of that. I have absolutely no doubt that my daughter was a gift from God to help me to overcome and survive this experience. And she will forever know that she changed her mother's life for the better.